Six people are presumed dead after a cargo ship named Dolly crashed into the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore this week. There are still many unanswered questions about what led to this horrific incident, but regulatory filings might provide some hints. Turns out that the company that chartered the ship was recently sanctioned by federal investigators for muzzling workers who voiced safety concerns. In fact, just 8 months prior to the horrific crash, the Labor Department sanctioned shipping conglomerate Maersk Line Limited for firing an employee who reported unsafe working conditions on a Maersk-operated boat. The worker, who was a chief mate and relief captain on the Maersk-operated SAF Marine Mafadi, reported unrepaired leaks, unpermitted alcohol consumption on board, inoperable lifeboats, faulty emergency fire suppression equipment, and other issues. And those are big issues. The Labor Department found that Maersk had a policy that requires employees to first report their concerns to the company prior to reporting it to the Coast Guard or other authorities. Federal regulators at the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, also known as OSHA, called the policy repugnant and a reprehensible and an egregious violation of the rights of employees, which chills them from contacting the Coast Guard or other authorities without contacting the company first. And guess what? OSHA was right in their analysis, since the company's policy violated the Seaman's Protection Act, which protects maritime workers who report violations to the Coast Guard from company retaliation. The legislation was amended in 2010 to add protections for employees who refuse to perform certain duties due to fears of personal injury. And yes, I said seaman and duty in the same sentence. Pretty amazing. When the Labor Department concluded their investigation into Maersk, they found that the censorious policy was approved by the company's executives. Maersk's vice president of labor relations admits that this reporting policy requires seamen to report safety concerns to the company and allow it time to abate the conditions before reporting to the Coast Guard or other regulatory agencies, Labor Department investigators said in their report. Regulators also ordered the company to reinstate the employee and pay over $700,000 in damages and back wages. I want to do that guy's job. How do we do that guy's job? You know, that sounds pretty good. They also demanded that Maersk revise its policy to allow seamen to contact the Coast Guard about safety concerns before notifying the company. Maersk is also in the middle of a legal battle with International Longshoremen's Association, which is a labor union representing 65,000 maritime workers. APM Terminals, a division of Maersk, sued the union, claiming employees at its Mobile, Alabama port were engaging in an illegal strike. Documents filed by the union in March alleged that the company illegally suspended six workers for raising a concern about a safety issue at the job site.
A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do. You know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us.
Look, this new reporting gives us some insight into the workplace culture at Maersk, which doesn't seem conducive to safe shipping operations. But it doesn't necessarily mean that there were known safety vulnerabilities aboard Dolly. Now that the black box, or what's the equivalent of the black box, has been recovered, we should await a full investigation into what really transpired. The Washington Post did report today that there was an issue discovered on the same cargo ship last year in June. Inspectors at the port of San Antonio, Chile, discovered a problem categorized as relating to propulsion and auxiliary machinery, according to the Tokyo MOU, an intergovernmental shipping regulator in the Asia-Pacific region. The issue was classified in the subcategory of gauges, thermometers, etc., but no additional details about the deficiency were provided. The problem was not serious enough to warrant detaining the ship, according to the records. And records also show, by the way, that after a follow-up inspection that was carried out later that same day, that Dolly was found to have no outstanding deficiencies, indicating that the problem was addressed. So as we await the results of a full investigation into what caused this horrible and destructive cargo ship collision, it's worth taking a moment to address one of the more politicized allegations floating around. Our friends on the right think that diversity, equity, and inclusion is to blame. Take Republican Congressman Jeff Van Drew from New Jersey, who wants to cut infrastructure regulations while focusing his ire on Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg and his culture war grievances.
Bottom line with Buttigieg is that he's worried too much about personal pronouns, worried too much about DEI policies, worried too much about, you know, being the cool kid on the block. And this has been a secretary that, quite frankly, even with the money that was allocated under the transportation infrastructure legislation, they're moving so slow on it because of regulation. We want to get these things going. So, you know, I'm disappointed in the job that he does. It's obvious that it's not about tree equity. It's not about personal pronouns. It's about that safety and the transportation of the people.
Yeah, sounds like this whole DEI argument is just meant to shift the conversation away from possible safety regulations, which corporate donors are known to lobby hard against. To nobody's surprise, Van Drew isn't the only one who's making this insane argument that DEI is to blame. And look, honestly, there are some elements of DEI that I think are not good and I've been critical of. This story is not a good example of that. But anyway, let's go back to other Republicans claiming that DEI should be blamed for this horrific incident that happened. Anthony Sabatini, a Republican running for Congress in Florida, tweeted a video of the crash with the caption, DEI did this. Of course, Sabatini, who sounds more like a cocktail than someone that's savvy enough to be a political player, didn't provide any evidence for his claim. Another right winger on X wrote, quote, shipping giant Maersk confirmed that the Dolly ship, operated and managed by Synergy Marine Group, collided with the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Maryland around 1:27 a.m. Synergy Marine Group promotes DEI in their company. Did anti-white business practices cause this disaster? There is literally zero evidence of that. And while it's true that Synergy Marine Group does manage Dolly, the ship is actually owned by Grace Ocean Private, a Singapore-based company. And all these companies really need to do a better job with their names, okay? Like the branding, really not up to par. And by the way, what do you know? They do have some skeletons in their closet, but they have nothing to do with DEI. So let's get into it. The New York Times reports, vessels belonging to the owner of the Baltimore ship had been cited for labor violations. The vessels had underpaid crews and kept workers on board for months beyond their contracts, according to an Australian regulator. But just wait, because it actually gets worse, if you could believe it. This post on X got lots of attention last night after Baltimore Mayor Brandon Scott, a black man, held a press conference to update the public on the status of the rescue operation. So let's take a look. Here we go. This account tweeted, this is Baltimore's DEI mayor commenting on the collapsed Francis Scott Key Bridge. It's going to get so, so much worse. Prepare accordingly. Maybe I'm the slow one here, but I'm having a hard time understanding how DEI comes into play when we're literally talking about an elected official, meaning the residents of this community voted for the mayor, for the guy who's currently mayor. He wasn't a corporate diversity hire for the morons who somehow forgot, you know, how elections work. Also, according to US Census data, the city of Baltimore was 62.3% black in 2022. So I guess if the city wanted to promote diversity, they should have elected a white mayor. Look, if you can believe it, others were even more explicit in their idiocy and racism. Former The Blaze host Elijah Schaefer sarcastically tweeted, breaking, mayor of Baltimore speaks out, with photo of Scott captioned, dat bridge be closed, yo. As the community note attached to the earlier tweet points out, Brandon Scott was elected as mayor of Baltimore in 2020 with more than 70% of the vote. He did not come into office through any DEI practices, appointments, etc. The implication in these conservative arguments that Scott somehow isn't qualified for his position and only got it because he's black is nonsense. Scott's rise to the mayor's office started at Big Brothers Big Sisters Baltimore, where he served as a mentor leader. In his transition to the city council, Scott, a native of the Park Heights neighborhood in Baltimore's northwest side and former high school and college track star, became a youth advocate. In 2011, Scott, an alumnus of St. Mary's College of Maryland, moved from city council staff to city council member. He spent 8 years on the city council before being elected mayor. Seems like he might be qualified. There's a reason conservatives are, in my opinion, flooding the zone with theories about DEI policies causing the cargo ship crash. For one, honestly, it's the new catnip for some right wingers and gets these pundits clicks and views. But also, it's a pretty clever way of averting people's attention from the things that might have actually led to these kinds of incidents and accidents happening, like weak and unenforced regulations, poor oversight of corporations, and political corruption. So don't be a sucker and don't get distracted.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.